Best team?
Best team.
I'm going to have to go with the 97-98 Chicago Bulls team, 72-10, with the greatest player of all time, Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan, great. Of all time.
All time.
Everybody.
Easily.
LeBron. By all of them.
Only person that comes close is Kobe Bryant. Kobe. And it's Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan.
I'm gonna have to agree with you. I personally take Michael over LeBron, but that's unpopular opinion for some people.
Yeah.
Welcome Michael. To LUTV Sports Extra. I'm Emily Sterling, along with Arthur Harmon. We're here to discuss everything extra in the world of sports.
Just when you thought the NBA couldn't get any better.
The NBA TV audience has been robbed of the joy of seeing James Harden, Chris Paul, and that other guy in those State Farm commercials. Please, let's have a moment of silence.
Lord, thank you for bringing us this NBA offseason. Thank you, Jesus.
Why is this happening? The Houston Rockets won a championship. Houston sent Paul and multiple first-round draft picks to Oklahoma City for former MVP Russell Westbrook. The trade reunites Harden and Westbrook, who are teammates on the Thunder for 3 seasons. Arthur, where does this trade rank Houston in the stacked Western Conference? And does this shoot the Houston Rockets all the way to a championship?
Honestly, I don't think so. It probably makes them better. I don't think so. It's a lot of ways it could go. They say Russell and James are friends, good friends. I don't know if they work out together. You know, back then when they played in OKC, they were much younger. James wasn't the superstar he is now. They were, you know, they had KD and they were good players. But you got Russell, you have James, and they're both pretty much ball dominant.
Yeah,
guys who get the ball.
That's gonna be hard.
And I don't think it shoots them a championship. It definitely puts them in the mix. There's a lot of ways things could go.
And I think that was an issue with Chris Paul and James Harden, is they were both kind of like, we want the ball, we want to shoot. And the thing with James Harden is James Harden likes to dribble all the way down the court, hold it for a little bit, do whatever, and then make like last minute
decisions, passes
and things like that.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that's going to fly with Russell Westbrook. And you also got to look at stats. I mean, James Harden's numbers are completely different from when he was at OKC.
Yeah, definitely was. And like I said, he wasn't a superstar. As soon as they traded him, I think his first game in Houston, what, he scored 45 points? His first game ever as a Houston Rocket, when he finally got, you know, to be a leader of a team. And you have Russell Westbrook, who, like you say, I don't think he's going to fly with that. But I don't know. I think NBA players have a thing where they can, like, gel well together, kind of, sort of, maybe so. But I really think who's a big factor in making all of this work is Mike D'Antoni.
Yeah.
Definitely. You got to look at him. He's such an offensive coach. Russell Westbrook isn't too much of a defensive player, but I say Russell brings a lot of energy as well to your team. That athletic ability he has and that competitive nature he has. So maybe in ways on the stat sheet he could bring to the Houston Rockets. Because, I mean, Chris Paul is a leader, but it seemed like when he wanted to lead, he wasn't like, you know, pretty much uplifting. I think Russell Westbrook, you know, when he shows that fire, having a teammate who shows fire would bring along a lot of people, you know, brings energy towards each other. So like I said, it really can work both ways. I don't think they're a championship team, however. Maybe if the league wasn't balanced, I say they probably would be in the mix again.
I think a problem with Houston is Houston is really big on looking at its big players, it's dominant players, like James Harden, Chris Paul. Look at your bench. I mean, you got Austin Rivers, Daniel House, all of them are young, can play good ball when they come in. I mean, kind of better them. I mean, see what they can do, see how you can bring them into making this team better. And not so much, oh, we have to have all these all-stars to make it to a championship.
Yeah, and I agree with you, like Austin Rivers, I haven't so much watched Austin Rivers in a few past years, but this year with Houston and how he played in that Golden State series, I think he definitely showed that, hey, I can bring something to this team. He definitely did. But, man, I really just, you know, I'm very curious of wondering how could this Houston team work. And like I said, it could go many ways. Russell lately, from his MVP winning season, he's scored, 30? He had averaged 31.8 points. But since then, he has decreased in scoring points. He's a 29% three-point shooter from the last past two seasons. So, and I think over there, you know, they're pretty much like a three-point shooting team. So,
definitely.
But Russ is not that, like how James Harden is, you know, kind of that Rocky to sleep, dribble quick and go and shoot. Russ doesn't really play like that. He likes to try to feed you. So I don't know. I don't think Russ could average a triple-double with them as well, because you got Clint Capela down there, P.J. Tucker down there,
yeah,
getting the rebound. So I don't know, man. Like, it's just that's why I don't think this year maybe is where they figure it out.
Yeah, I think so.
You know, you still got – I don't know how much longer that Russ has on the contract, but definitely this year I think they figure it out. And if they win while figuring it out, that only makes them better for the next season. And like we said last week, it's a lot of ways things can go. And, like, I say whoever stays healthy has the best advantage, because a lot of people could get hurt. Of course, we're all thinking, you know, everybody looks good on paper, but injuries are a part of the game. So that's a big factor.
I think it's going to see how – I think someone's going to have to compromise. Either they're both going to have to give a little. Like, James is going to have to maybe dribble down the court faster and kind of give it to somebody else. Or Russell Westbrook's going to have to learn how to maybe pick up the pace of how he shoots, and waiting to the last minute is okay for him.
Yeah.
So one of them is going to have to compromise, or both of them are going to have to give a little bit.
Yeah.
So they're definitely – it's going to change how both of them play.
Yeah.
Because I think it's not going to work if you don't.
Yeah, like how James has been scoring so much dominantly in the game, I think he's going to have to sacrifice that a little bit. And how Russ always takes those silly shots. And just, you know, being the one to take those shots – he's going to have to sacrifice that. And that's not even a bad thing. I think that's a good thing, because sometimes he takes those shots where it's just so deflating when you miss them. For your team, you're just like, wow, he's just missing. So I think he's going to have to make smarter decisions. He's definitely going to have to become a better shooter. So that helps them out. But he can bring, like I say, he can bring that energy, the athletic ability he has. He's definitely way more athletic than Chris Paul was, and younger. So, yeah. James Harden's going to have to sacrifice how much he scores. And like you said, he's going to have to pick up the pace.
And, I mean, he feeds off of those 50-plus point games.
Yes.
I don't know if he's going to want to give some of that up.
That's hard, too. And he's been playing like that for a while now. So, like you said, but they're going to have to compromise. I definitely agree with you when you say that. They're going to have to compromise, and they're going to have to – and I have to come up to something. But like I said, who really plays a big factor in what they do is Mike D'Antoni, for sure, because he's the one that, you know, calls the plays, tells them what to do. So if they go by where he goes, and if he has a great plan for Russell and James to work together, maybe it can work. But if he's just like, go out there and play basketball, it's going to be some ups and downs for the Houston Rockets all year.
I definitely think it's going to be a learning experience for the whole team.
Whole team, definitely. But making it about Russ and James, I think it's, you know, because they're big superstars, but everybody around that team is going to have to pick up as well, because Clint Capela, he's going to have to be a better player.
Yeah, sometimes he fizzles out.
Fizzles, yeah, definitely. Like, I say he's a great center when he wants to be, but in the Golden State series this past season, this past postseason, was not good at wasn't effective really at all. And I feel like
I don't think any of them were really effective.
Not so much, but DeMarcus Cousins went down, and I feel like that was a big opportunity for Clint to, you know, get his.
Yeah.
Definitely, but he didn't. But I feel like last year in the Western Conference Finals, Clint did a lot to hurt the Warriors in a way, but I feel like the Warriors did a lot this year to keep Clint Capela out of that. And then if you know James Harden drives down the lane, and if you know he brings that Draymond in and just throws the floater to Clint, but they stopped that this year. But yeah, they definitely have to get better as a team this year, and it's just not going to be about Russell and James. You know, mostly it is, but still, their bench, those role players, going to have to do their job as well. But I feel like it was a gutsy move by Houston as well. But
it definitely was. It shocked a lot of people. Especially how the West already is.
Yeah, definitely. And I feel like OKC now is just like, you know, Russell has been through it all and been with us through thick and thin. It's kind of like, it wasn't like he demanded a trade, but it was like, we owe this guy something. So let's go trade him to a contender maybe. And let's start to rebuild. So OKC is definitely rebuilding. And they definitely gave a lot of players away. Victor Oladipo.
I mean, when you think about it, when James was first at OKC, I mean, it was Harden, Westbrook, and KD.
Now it's...
So, I mean,
Steven Adams.
You got to think about it. I mean, if Russ wants to get any better, get even close to a championship, he knew he was going to have to go somewhere else no matter how much it hurt him.
Mm-hmm. You're absolutely right. And he was showing that loyalty, but it was only so long he could do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for tuning into LUTV Sports Extra. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter to keep up with everything extra in the world of sports. See you next time.
I felt like that conversation was great.
Yeah,
that
was good.
Yeah. I feel like I'm on ESPN or something, you know?
Yeah, I'm just telling him a good time, do whatever.
Yeah. Emily is a great co-host.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I'm her co-host, my fault.